Welcome back. You're watching HFO-TV.
Welcome back to HFO-TV. I'm Lee Fehrenbacher. Here today with me is Walt McMonies of Council with Lane Powell. Walt is here to talk about the City of Portland's movement towards seismic upgrades in unreinforced masonry buildings. Welcome.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Just as background, I wanted to tell people that you're currently a member of the Oregon Seismic Safety Policy Advisors Committee.
OSPAC.
OSPAC. As well as the historic preservation group, Restore Oregon.
Correct.
The city's Bureau of Emergency Management has come out with a plan for retrofitting old brick buildings that appears to be headed toward the city council next year for consideration. I think the last time that you and I ran into each other was at the Seismic Retrofit Support Committee. How long have you been involved in that process?
Well, I wasn't appointed to the committee, but they started in last fall and I started attending those meetings, and eventually I attended the meetings more than half the members, so they sort of unofficially put me on the committee.
Okay. How did that all come about? I mean, you've been actually writing and involved in this subject for several years now. How did this all process come about?
Well, years ago, they did an inventory of unreinforced masonry buildings in Portland. It came up with 1,765 buildings, and I know the people at BDS, Bureau of Development Services, have been concerned about those unreinforced masonry buildings for years. And now Emergency Services, which is under Commissioner Novick, they were concerned about it. And then you had PDC somewhat concerned as well, because they were financing buildings that were unreinforced masonry. Mm-hmm. So you had the confluence of Commissioner Novick's interest, Emergency Services' interest, BDS and PDC. So critical mass came together, and about a year ago they started this process.
Okay. You own several buildings downtown as well. As I mentioned, you've written extensively on the issue of seismic retrofits for unreinforced masonry buildings. What's at stake for you personally in this process?
Well, you know, I'm one of those people that's going to go ahead and retrofit my building regardless of what the city does.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel it's important for my tenants, and I feel it's the buildings that I have to do it on are buildings I really love, and I want them to survive a major earthquake. So I'm going to go ahead and do it. So I personally don't have a big stake in anything, but we formed a group called Masonry Building Owners of Oregon, which reflects as his members, I would say about half of the people who own mm-hmm. apartment buildings that are unreinforced masonry.
Okay.
And those people are very concerned because it's an enormous financial burden to do a seismic upgrade.
Yeah.
I'm well into, I spent $500,000 on one building, and I'm proposing to spend another $600,000 or $700,000 to finish it off. And that's a 46,000 square foot building. And, you know, we happen to be fortunate for various, you know, there's federal tax credits, there's the state property tax abatement, things like that have helped us do this. But that isn't available to people who don't have historic buildings. Neither of those programs are. But anyway, I've been sort of insulated from the horrors of it because of that, because I started out on this a long time ago, and I've been working on it dutifully and spreading the expenditures out over many years. But what the typical building owner is going to face is the need to do this within probably 20 years, starting from scratch, mm-hmm. with an upgrade that is very helpful to the building for its survival from an earthquake, but it doesn't add much value to the building in terms of rentability to tenants or anything like that, curb appeal.
So then the question is how do we incentivize this this work? How do we help owners afford to do the work that's needed? The reports I've read have been anywhere between $5 and $10 for your very basic life safety improvements, up to north of $50 a square foot.
Oh, for the cost of doing it, yeah.
Yeah,
you're definitely in the $30 to $50 per square foot if you've got a four-story building that is a true unreinforced masonry building.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm going to be in it to the tune of $30 to $35 a square foot when I get it all.
And that's Trinity Place Apartments.
Right.
Yeah. And so when did you start looking at doing that project?
We started looking at it probably 5 or 6 years ago, and we actually started doing it in 2011 or 12. We did it in installments over the course of about 18 months to get to where we are now, which is what they call Bolts Plus.
Okay. Okay.
And again, we still have the major one major thing to do, and that is the strengthening of the exterior walls.
Okay. You're unique in that you're taking the initiative now to do that project kind of early on, before potentially the city mandates these seismic upgrades, before there are programs to kind of help owners to afford to do the updates. But you know, why should owners be concerned about this issue?
Well, it's an enormous financial impact, obviously. $35 a square foot is real money. So if you have a 20,000 square foot building, you're looking at $700,000.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that is not pocket change. And the trouble is most non-building owners, people who aren't in the real estate industry, they don't understand. They go, oh, well, gee, just go spend X dollars, you know, $35 a square foot. You know, you guys have lots of cash flow. Well, most of us do have pretty good cash flow, but it goes to pay a mortgage, it goes to pay operating expenses, it goes to pay taxes. There isn't just a ton of money left over out of operating income to go and spend $700,000.
You read the New Yorker article that came out recently, kind of you know, really bringing to life the impact of the Cascadia subduction zone earthquake, if that were to happen. And you had an interesting conversation shortly thereafter with some people.
One of my lender friends, sometime client, called me up and said, gee, my credit guy back on the East Coast is really concerned about this article he read in the New Yorker, and you know, should we be pulling our loans out of Oregon and Washington? I mean, and as far as I know, he's serious. That's what the guy told him.
Yeah.
And so it's created an enormous amount of awareness of this of the problem, of the earthquake threat in Oregon and mm-hmm. Washington, and it's because it comes from a publication that's so well known to the sort of the elite on the East Coast. You know, people who are hedge fund, you know, managers and insurance company executives, you know, they read the New Yorker, they read the Atlantic, they read Harper's, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
These are intellectual magazines. This stuff has credibility that it didn't have when the same article was written in the Oregonian or the Seattle Times. People weren't paying attention back on the East Coast.
Sure.
Now
sure.
They are.
And rightfully so.
Yeah, I think so.
Mm-hmm. Is there an opportunity for owners to get involved at this point in time?
Well, sure. You've audited some of the meetings of the mm-hmm. of the city task force, and I started out auditing that. Yeah, I think anybody who wants to come to those meetings, they're open meetings.
Mm-hmm.
You can learn a lot by going to the meeting, and you may have something significant to contribute.
Okay.
And so I would encourage people who are concerned about the issue to come to these meetings of the city task force on URMs.
Okay. And information about when those meetings are being held is available on the Portland Development Commission's website.
Yeah, I think it's either Emergency Services or Portland Development. Yeah, one or both of them have links to the agendas, to the minutes of the past meetings, to the study reports and proposed, you know, regulations and so on. So yeah, you can find out a lot just going to the city website.
Okay, all right. Well, thank you, Walt. I appreciate you coming in and joining us. That's all the time we have for HFO-TV. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Great.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you.
Our entire office specializes in multifamily real estate, making HFO the largest multifamily brokerage in the Pacific Northwest. Your success is our passion. Build your legacy with HFO. Call 503-241-5541 or visit our website at HFORE.com for more information.